In this video, we're going to go over the book module in Lightroom. Looking at it, the layout is very similar to the other modules. In the center will be your book that you're working on with the individual pages. Over on the left-hand side, we can work directly from our existing collections. I recommend that you start creating a collection for your book. Remember, you can always add to it at any time. And the kind of working part of the module is over here on the right-hand side. Starting with the first panel, the book settings, please make sure that you're using the correct settings for the publication that we're going to do, and you'll find those settings on the blog post, or you should have taken notes in class. But this tells you what kind of a book you're going to do, if you're working with blurb or creating a PDF, which is what we're doing. The next is the size. The two sizes that do perfect bindings in MagCloud are standard portrait or small square, are fairly easy ones to do. The quality of the images. The color profile, and for online printing, we're going to use sRGB. The file resolution, we're going to use 300. And you can list then sharpening, standard, and glossy. If when you first click over into the book module, all your images are automatically kind of laid out, just click this button here, Clear Layout. That's going to start you over. And the one additional thing that we're using is no cover, since we're printing through MagCloud. If you're printing through Blurb, then you would probably use a cover. Okay, continuing down, so we have clear layout. If it's already laid out all your images, and that starts you over. Below that, we have add page, and the way it works is whatever kind of a page you're on at the time, when you add page, it's going to add another one just like that. And I recommend that you always use add page as opposed to add blank. If you want to see the guides on the page, simply click show guides. They don't print, so you don't have to worry about that. Below that, I'll show you what we can use cell padding for, and photo text. And the last one then, so we've got type, if you want to add type to a page, and we've got background, if you want to create a color for the background or put an image there. And then our button here when we're ready to export. So looking at the center window, you have multiple ways to view. Right now I'm in the multi-page view. I can go into the spread view, which shows me the images that would be facing each other on a spread. And then the next one is just the single page view. I'm going to go back to spread. When you click on an image or on a page, you have a couple of options. And one of them is how to add type. The two ways are you can add it as page text, and so I go over here to the right-hand column, click page text, up comes the little area that I can add it in, and I can start typing, and then it works pretty much like any other Word document. We go down into the type panel. Once I've selected the type, you can then change the font that you're using. You can change the color of it. So for example, if you're putting type over a dark photograph, you'd probably want a light colored type. You can change the size of it. I've found that 11 point works well for reading type. The opacity of it and whether it's justified, flush left, flush right, all of those work. You have a second option then. So I've got my page text, and that's photo text. So I'm going to drag an image onto this page. My page type is still there, and I can click on photo text and add more type. With both photo text and page text, you have the offset, which allows you a pretty good freedom in terms of where you want that text to go. And so both of those will move the text throughout the page. Padding refers to, and so let me put some type onto this page here. I'm going to bring it up where we can see it, and I'm going to use a very big, a very big font. I've selected the type, going to click character and white. And so the second thing that you have to say where exactly the type or the image is going to go is padding. And the further you press and drag this, the further in it goes from its existing boundaries. So for example, I'm selected on the type, it moved the type, I can select on the image, and it can drag in where that's going to go from its outside. The last thing that you really need to know about is the layout option. So it's pretty wonderful. When you click on a page, you'll see you get this orange boundary comes up, and we simply click on the little pop-up, say how many images you're interested in using. Once you select that, then below it, there are a whole set of different layouts that you can use. And just click on that, and I'm going to zoom in. So right now this is a 3-page, but you'll notice that this isn't filling it. Once you click on the image, you can then zoom it and press and drag. You can actually use the same image multiple times on a photo. So if you wanted to kind of do a special effect, let's say with some space in between them, you could, using this method, where we could add multiple images or an image multiple times on a page and break it up. So that's the overall use of the book module. As you get started, you'll then want to click Create Saved Book. That will save the work that you've done so far, and when you come up, it will constantly save, when you come back to the book module, it will constantly have that last previous work that you did available. And then you can immediately, let's say if you want to edit an image, you can always pop into the develop module, change that image, and go back to the book module, and those changes will be reflected in the image as you see it. And that's how to use it.